Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video I want to talk about the SAP Cloud Platform Integration Suite and how we can use Power Automate to simplify some of the daily operations. Before I go to the actual scenario, let me quickly spend a few minutes on the SAP Cloud Platform Integration Suite itself. So the Integration Suite contains out of several products, API management, open connectors, and so on. But there's one piece that I want to focus today, and that's the integration solution. The integration solution really allows us to connect SAP to SAP systems, SAP to non-SAP system, just to connect different server sides, component with each other. Now, the huge benefit from my point of view of the integration suite is actually the huge amount of pre-configured available integration flows that are available on the SAP API Business Hub. So instead of doing a mapping of success factors to Ariba, from Salesforce to my S4HANA system and all this kind of stuff, what I can do, I can just look at the API Business Hub, search for available content, and then take one of the pre-configured content already and make it available in my very own integration suite. This means that instead of doing all the mappings by myself, always adjusting this to maybe some changes in an e-government scenario, SAP is doing this for me. And to get started, obviously, that really, really simplifies my life quite a lot. Now, when I connect these different systems, then in a lot of cases, what we have is that we do the security, the authorization with certificates. So obviously, the integration suite has for this a key store where all the available certificates are kept. Now, unfortunately, these certificates, or fortunately, these certificates have an expiration date. So one task that the administrator has to do is you always need to look at, well, if a certificate expires, I need to go in there, I need to renew it, I need to create a new one, so to say. And this is obviously something that you might easily forget. In a lot of cases, these certificates are valid for 2 years or 5 years, and you somehow need to remember that when the time comes, you need to replace these services. So what we can now do is we can create a Power Automate workflow that would basically, for example, check every day the key store service, look through all the available certificates, check if they will expire in a month from now, in 2 weeks from now, in whatever time frame from now, and then inform me if some action needs to be taken. And that's actually what I quickly want to show you in this specific demo here. All the configurations of the Power Automate flow are also available on GitHub. So just head over there, give it a try. It's really fairly easy. So let's take a look. From the SAP Cloud Platform cockpit, we can enable and access the Cloud Platform integration services. So here I can just click on Go to Application, and we'll open up the integration suite site. And down there I can see the cloud integration. So I've already activated everything. So I can just click on this application, and I'm in the cloud integration dashboard. So here in a second, you can see all the available services and stuff like that, that I could just enable and use to integrate SAP and non-SAP systems. Now, one very, very important thing, and what I think really is a huge value add of the whole integration suite, is this pre-configured content. So if I go to the API Business Hub here, I select integration, then I can actually take a look at all the out-of-the-box integration services, the iFlows that are available for the integration suite. So I can browse here, and let's just take a look at one of these services here for customer relation management. I can just take a look at here at the integration tab, and I can see the services or the flows that are available here. So in this specific case, you can see there's a sender, there's a start item. So the whole flow is already pre-configured by SAP. And the only thing that I would need to do is take it and make it available in my client. So if I go back to my client, I can go to the monitoring tab, and there we'll find, obviously an overview of what's actually happening. And in my system, there's not much, but what I want to take a close look is the key store. So obviously when we talk about these integrations, we need to authenticate, we need to encrypt and so on. So the key store is a very important piece in this integration. Now, certificates always have the thing that they are valid until a certain date. So you can see some of these services are valid till 2030 or something like that. But I also created services that expire in 2 years or in a week from now. So obviously, what I want to do, I want to be able to detect whenever such a certificate expires. And before it actually expires, I want to exchange it. So luckily, the SAP Cloud Platform provides me with an API to actually access this key store. And again, here from the API Business Hub, I can just take a look at the relevant services. And you can see there's a key store entry service, an OData service that allows me to query the certificates that are available currently in my key store. So the Business Hub actually allows me to browse a certain sample configuration, but I can also, and that's what I did, I have configured my own Cloud Platform integration service. So I can just select the system and I can test this OData service. So I click on execute here, and you can see this is the whole list of certificates that are available in my specific key store. So if I look here for Holger, that's exactly one of the certificates that I had created and that in this specific case will expire probably next week. So what I now want to do is I want to actually create a service that would regularly check the key store and see if there is a certificate that will expire, let's say, in 2 weeks from now. And I want to inform the administrator that there is something that they need to do. So in order to call this API that we just detected, I actually need to go to my process integration service. And you can see there's also a service plan for APIs. This service plan allows me to access the Cloud Platform integration services via an API call. So what I've done, I've already created a so-called service key that allows me to do an OAuth authentication to this very specific API service and then retrieve the relevant data. So if I switch over to Power Automate, I've now everything in place that I need. And from Power Automate, I can create a flow, and I've done this already. And actually, like mentioned in the description, this flow is available also on GitHub. It runs every day at 8 a.m. I've specified the token URL. So that's the very same information from this service key. So this is the token URL. I've specified it here in the flow. I've specified the client ID, client secret, and the generic URL that I'll call. And then I create the first fetch access token. So I do a post method. I post to the token URL. I specify the client credentials grant type. I provide the client ID and client secret. And then when I do this, I actually get the access token back. With this access token, I can then really make my call to the key store entry service. And that's basically it. And once I have the key store service, I can pass the results. And you remember, the information from the API Business Hub was this list of all the available certificates. So with a lot of different fields. So what I'll do, I'll filter only for alias, key type, key size, and most importantly, obviously, the valid not after field. I need to change the format a little because I get a timestamp back. But then I can really look at this timestamp and say, well, if this timestamp is less than the current time plus 2 weeks, for example, so it's greater than this specific time, then I want to send an email, or then I want to highlight that there is a certificate that will expire very soon. So I'll set a status action required, and I'll append this very specific certificate to an array of certificates that need some action. I'll also create then an HTML table out of this, and I'll also create an HTML table with all the available certificates. And then as a last step, I'll just send out this email with a certain status certificates, and if there are certificates that will expire with this status certificate explanation that this expires, and that's it. So with this, I can either test quickly the service, I mean, or I could wait till the next day at 8 a.m. But if I test the service here, so I run the flow, and in a second we can immediately see the results. So you can see, yes, it was triggered successful. We retrieved all the token URLs. You can see here the URL and stuff like that. Obviously, client ID. The first interesting thing is this fetch access token. So I do this post with the client ID and so on. And you can see in the body, I get the access token. So that's the result that I got from the SAP Cloud platform. Then I can take this result. I'll parse it. I'll make a JSON format, an understandable JSON format for me in Power Automate. And then I just take the access token. You can see here, I put the access token in the authorization, and then I get as a result the full list of certificates back from the CPI service. So with this information, then I again parse the whole results. I parse the list of all the certificates, and then I can go to this specific apply for each section. So for each certificate, I go through, I check whether this certificate is still valid in 2 weeks from now, and hopefully we'll find one. Here we go. So this one is, well, let's go back. So this one is will expire in 2 weeks from now. So let's take a look. I'll set the action required status, and then I'll just append it to an array that's called action required list. So this will expire next week, this certificate, so I'll add it to this specific list. Then, yeah, well, I just compose the email, I create an HTML table out of it, I compose the email, and I send the email to the administrator. So if I switch over to the email, that's actually what you see. So at the top, first of all, we see action required. So I, at the administrator, know, oh, there's something that I need to do. I see in the top the certificates that I need, where I need to take some action. So you can see it will expire in a few days. And down at the bottom, I have the list of all the certificates. Okay, I hope you saw the value in a simple integration as this. Now, ideally, you want to get your hands dirty. So I can only recommend sign up to the SAP Cloud platform, activate the platform integration service. There's actually a nice blog that really outlines you step by step, actually how to sign up to the SAP Cloud platform and then how to activate the integration services. Once you have done this, head over to Power Automate. You can import the sample that I made available here on GitHub. You obviously need to adjust it. You need to specify your very own client secrets, client credentials, like outlined in the video. And then that's it. Then you can immediately get started. Feel free, obviously, to adjust the email to your specific scenario and let me know what you think. I hope you enjoyed this quick video. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe. Stay healthy.